Hello everyone, and thank you for coming back to my channel. That is Deb Chanel's 48th World, and let me re-say that again. I messed up when I said my channel. I meant to say our channel. Thank you for coming to our channel, Deb Chanel's 48th World, because it's a family affair over here. Yes, it is. It's a family affair. It's a family affair. I got my family with me. We're in the camp. And we gonna set it off. Yes, we are going to do that right now. Okay, guys. Thought I'd give y'all that little entertainment, okay? Welcoming you on into the house. Come on in. Come on in. Sit down. Go to the kitchen. Get you something to drink. If you bought your food, sit at the table. Sit on the sofa. And let's chit-chat a little bit, okay? Because we're gonna go way back. We're gonna go about 8 days back where... Excuse me, Radar Online brought out this really interesting story about the reality TV girls on the Real Housewives of whatever county or state. They on the chopping block, okay? And Nene is on one of them. So I'm guessing, yeah, she must be got that lawyer. Oh, what her name was? Something Bloom? Lisa Bloom, I think it was, to represent her, because woo-wee, somebody gonna have to be doing some downsizing if that is in fact true to form or what they got going on. But before we go into that, I want to say thank you for some family members that dropped over to the house today and late last night. Walter Brown, yes, Spice Life TV, Sanderitz, Beatrice Holland, and Joanne C. Hello, and thank you for stopping by to, yes, get into this commentary we got going on here. Y'all know I get down, and then I ask y'all to get in them comments. Y'all tell me what y'all think about subject matter, okay? Not me, but subject matter, because you know I'm going to cut up all day, every day. Yes, my mouth, Val Williams, got on me, talking about I'm cussing too much. I'm like, Val, if they didn't give me a reason to cuss, I wouldn't be cussing so much. But sometimes you got to throw the four F's out there. Sometimes people be acting fake. They be acting fraudulent. They be having you up looking at some fuckery type shit. And the foolery that drape your screen or on whatever trending on social media, you got to give it to them, okay? If they ain't giving me nothing and they don't occupy my time, guess what? I got to defend myself because they took away time that I can't get back. So when things happen like that, Val Williams, we got to regulate, okay? Don't waste my time. I won't waste yours. I'm here to love on y'all, give y'all some sort of entertainment. At least, hell, that's what I be trying to do sometimes. Hell, I be tickling myself out too much, okay? I be laughing at my own self. So, if I'm putting myself on the block for y'all to partake of, then damn, give me some room to probably make y'all chuckle here and there. It's all entertainment. It's all in fun. We all had a rough day, some of us, and sometimes we just want to come and turn on the TV and look at some mindless drama stuff that we can get a kiki out of. Sometimes you want to get on the tube and listen to content creators that, you know, want to express themselves, okay? That's all I'm saying. So give me some room to breathe, Val. Fall back off of me, okay? But anyway, that's my family member. I could have sworn I got rid of her, though. But I guess she can't. Maybe for some reason she's here to stay. So Val, give me some room now. Give me some room. So you can make your ideas known and I can make my ideas known and we can stay in the family together because one of us gonna go, okay? But I'm just saying, give me some room. Give me 50 feet now. But I still love you. Yes, I do. But we got rules and regulations over here at our channel, Deb Chanel's 48th World. We don't come in the platform being rude. We express our opinions. We treat everybody like we want to be treated. You know, you're going to have some little banter. You're going to have a little bit going back and forth. But ain't no sense of calling nobody out their names. Let's not do all that. We ain't on Real Housewives of Atlanta. We ain't got no time to be calling nobody in the family any bad words. You know what I'm saying? Because we got to come back. We got to love on each other. And then, we, you know, sometimes we feel bad about certain things. And we got to come and say, okay, I'm sorry. I apologize. guys. Don't happen too often, but it happens, okay? So anyway, we're going to go on and get right on into this story, this article that I pulled from Radar Online, okay? And I'm trying to figure out who wrote this little piece, but we can always say a staff writer if they don't want to shout out their members of who's been, you know, writing up these salacious stories for us to partake of and find some truth, or it just might be a ton of lies. We don't know, okay? But we just digesting it and see what we come up with it from our own perspectives and opinions. But they give us a title called Reality Chopping Block. Bravo Axing Housewives Lucrative Deals. And it was put out on February 5th. Okay, going on into the article. It says, reality check. Okay, Bravo is axing all of the housewives lucrative deals. RadarOnline.com has exclusively learned. After getting rid of highly paid Vicky Gunvalson and Tamara Judge on The Real Housewives of Orange County, the network is on a major cost-cutting rampage across every franchise, and no one is safe. Okay, do we think that's a rumor, or do we think it's true? Well, I'm telling you, I don't really watch the Orange County Housewives. I used to watch Beverly Hills and Potomac. I think it was New York. But, you know, I kind of got bored with them, so I came on back home to Atlanta and saw what these women were giving me down here, okay? Which was a bunch of shit. They wasn't giving me nothing too much, but they were reading a little bit harder than the Caucasian women can do, okay? But anyway, because Caucasian women, they like to sue. They like hit me, and I'm going to sue, all right? They handle their shit in court. Black women, we just bite all day. We be calling each other itches and O's and all this kind of stuff. I don't, but we do have some women who's very well, they're very well intelligent. They're well groomed. They know how to conduct themselves. But honey, you get to talking about their man or them per se, or get into their space, you're going to see another whole beast come out of them. All right. And we call it the hood beast. All right. But anyway, going back to the article, it says Bravo has rolled out a new talent agreement, which doesn't guarantee the ladies will be featured in every episode, an insider dish to Radar. No one is safe, noted the source. They will no longer be given huge contracts to the returning ladies. Okay, so I don't think nobody gonna be trying to go nowhere, because they said if you leave and come back, you may just be getting $50 an hour. I'm just lying, y'all just lying. Woo! But no, they're saying with you coming back, talking about you want to come back for $1 million+, and you've been gone for maybe 2 seasons or whatnot. Hell, one season. You might be coming back making $100,000. Okay, and that's enough. That's enough, honey. Because how they claim it, and I'm just speaking on the Housewives of Atlanta, because those are the ones I talk about on a regular basis. They can't do that with no $100,000, because they definitely have superseded their income level to how we say keeping up with the Joneses. All right. Yes. Okay. And I heard one of them, I think it was Nene, who said, hell, she is one of the Joneses. I was like, oh, Lord. Oh, my goodness. So hopefully all the women on Real Housewives of Atlanta have saved some money while they were flossing and glossing out here in these streets, because they definitely look much better. How they say money can make you look fabulous, make you look like $1 million. You go back to when they first started the Real Housewives of Atlanta, and how they were dressed and how they were looking, and as far as their appearance, and you look at them now. Honey, they act like that. And Nene got lighter overnight, and everything got them teeth fixed. Start wearing blonde wigs on the regular. Just a hot mess, I tell you. You can't forget where you came from, because how you got up them stairs, you got to come back down them stairs, whether you coming back because you want to, or they done threw you down them stairs and said the door was closed, okay? And in Nene's case, the door is closed, because she has definitely not been featured a lot like she has been in previous seasons. And I think it has a lot to do with her representation of bringing Lisa Bloom on in to be a threat of some sort, even if she don't necessarily litigate for her in the future or currently, but just to know she has someone on retainer and they're trying to more than likely handle things behind the scenes, you know, off camera. But I'm like, this need to be on camera. Now that would be some good ass drama, Bravo. Y'all missing out. But anyway, that's my pun intended. If you really want to make some money, you need to tell her what's going on and how this stuff being filmed. All right, now that's real reality TV right there. In a nutshell, you talking about the Raiders would go through the roof. Shit. We'll be sitting there trying to figure out what Nene really makes and all of that. I mean, you got to show your taxes to the tax accountant. You run for a political office, you got to show your taxes. So why I'm just going to show us your taxes, Nene? We can't do nothing for you but keep supporting you by watching the show. And that, my friend, is powerful, okay? But when nobody's checking for you and they moving on to another whole avenue, then you need to worry, honey. You need to worry, but you got too far big in them britches of yours, okay? You start thinking you couldn't even talk to the common folks, the folks that were rude for you from day one. So, yeah, Nene, you need to check your own self, because I'm sure we done checked you to you, your butt is raw back there, okay? So now you need to do some mirror. Get in that mirror and do some self-evaluation, baby. But anyway, going back to the article, that was all my pun, my sidebar that I usually do, okay, from time to time when I'm on the air with you guys. But going back to the article, it says the insider insisted this was a clever tactic to amp up the drama for the women from the Real Housewives of Orange County and Atlanta, New York City, New Jersey, and even Beverly Hills franchises. The ladies are uneasy about the new contracts, and now they know they have to deliver the drama or risk not getting paid, the source explained to Radar. Scroll through the gallery for more exclusive details about the Housewives taking a huge financial cut. Okay, we'll do that. All right, second place, they say, after Tamara and Vicky were axed from Real Housewives of Orange County, Kelly Dodd was second only to Shannon Beardore in salary. Last woman standing, Real Housewives of Atlanta star Nene Leakes, 3 years. A 3-year $2.85 million contract was the last of its kind. Woohoo! So what, they gonna be getting paid $80,000, $90,000? What is it? It must be in the thousands now. It ain't gonna be ever in the millions, it seems like, because they said $2.85 million contract dollar was given out to Nene, and that's the last of its kind. Okay. My sidebar, I guess it don't matter how much drama you bring to the table, they ain't gonna pay you no more of a $2.85 million contract. So what can we say about Kenya Moore? Kenya Moore, you came back from getting cut to a $500,000 salary. So, what are you gonna get paid now? $600,000? Child, you better be amping up your $1 million business you were just talking about on the last episode that you said Tanya was kind of tainting you, pulling back some sales because of what she had said and ousting you out, that you're not only using your client, well, your products, if you made to say you don't have to use any accessories like wigs and extensions and all of that stuff, to where Tanya sat out there and put that you also wear pieces to make your hair fuller or a downright laced wig front. Okay, so that was more so embarrassing you. It wasn't necessarily Tanya was tainting your revenue sales, because we all know, those who had eyes to see, that wasn't your real hair. It was just too full, okay? And when we've seen your hair in past, where you having people part your hair and show, you know, the length of your hair is really kind of flat, and I wouldn't say it's thin, but it's not full, okay? It's not full. So anyway, moving back from that situation, it says the insider told Radar that the ladies would now only be paid for the episodes they appear on, not the whole season. So basically, if you have season 12, for an example, and it has 15 episodes, and you're only being shown in 3 of them, woohoo, that is a major cut. You might would just come on off the show. So either you bringing in drama where people just like glued to their TV sets, or you're not bringing the drama and you won't be featured. And that seems like that's what's going on with Miss Nene Leakes, okay? They're playing hardball. But that's all my sidebar. Let's go back to another Real Housewives of New Jersey. They have a title, a subtitle called Budget Unfriendly. Teresa Gudenz loves to shout that the Real Housewives of New Jersey is her show, but the Garden State ladies were the first to get paid per episode only. Okay, woo-hoo-hoo. We got another one, Poor Little Rich Girl. Her husband may be worth $100 million, but Kylie Richards and the rest of the ladies in Beverly Hills will likely be paid, or will likely be put on a budget too. Everyone is going to have a negotiation about their money, the source told Radar. Okay, then we got Hurt Pride. We got Tamara Judge admitted she walked away from a $60,000 to return for just 3 episodes. Okay, they only giving her $60,000 to be featured. How long in the scene? I don't know, but they just giving her $60,000. Hell, you can't even buy a Maserati for that. Lord have mercy. I tell you, when you drink the Satan's or the devil's potion, it comes back to bite you in the butt, doesn't it now? Woo, but you already done sacrificed your soul. Okay, but going back to the article, it says, they want to pay her $60,000 to return for just 3 episodes. That was Tamara Judge. A source told Radar, the offer was humiliating. I bet it was. But see, I think they don't pay these housewives too much money to where it's cutting into their profit. You see what I'm saying? And the stakes just keep going up. If they bring in the drama, they feel another couple of million need to be set aside for their salary. Okay? It doesn't matter on how long or whenever they get put in the scenes, they still guaranteed that type of salary. All right? Radar said, Got another subtitle called Bye-Bye. That's Vicki Gunderson. Had enough and left the show after 14 seasons. A source close to production told Radar, it's the end of an era. And I'm like, good Lord, honey. 14, you should have been left anyway. But they had to kind of throw you out, force you out too. But you said, I'm gone. I see the writing on the wall. But you made yourself get into a lucrative position to where you're going to. That's Vicki, y'all. She's going to have a podcast of some sort. So that's going to be interesting for those who like Vicki. Go on over there and check her out. All right. Then another subtitle was called Family Feud. We got Melissa Gorga made sure that she was paid the same as Teresa during her Real Housewives of New Jersey contract negotiations. Okay, like whoa, that is a moment. Okay, I'm like, ooh, Andy, what are you doing? What are you doing to your ladies over there? You trying to clean house so you can start back at signing people up for at least $100,000 per season? The million dollar contract, is it cutting up into your paycheck? And come on and tell us the real truth. The really real truth. Okay. But that's all I got, y'all. Y'all get down on them comments and tell me what y'all thought about this cross the board Bravo cutting them 1 million plus contracts, making them women think about where they came from and hell, where they might have to go back to. Okay, so that's why I say, when you sitting up here climbing this ladder of success and hugging on everybody, stepping on everybody, talking about everybody, trying to get to that golden gate, okay, and you done sold your soul, everything that glitter ain't gold. Hold on, guys. everything that glitters ain't gold. And when you sit up there and trample on people trying to make it to that top to be the superstar of all superstars, and everybody like, look at me type of mentality you got. Honey, when they shut them doors and they tired of you and say, oh, you done had your time. It's just like when you're acting or you're modeling and whatnot. They already have a cutoff period. Once you experience that cutoff period, they don't care how much they like you, love you, whatever. Honey, they just say they can't do you no more. You know what I'm saying? Then you be like all frantic, worrying about, well, what I'm going to do? I got this, I got that. You think that's their problem? They're like, you should have been thinking about that, because nothing, and I do mean nothing, lasts forever. Okay, all right. So, fam, y'all get down in them comments. Y'all tell me what y'all thought about it, if you care to. It's no rush. It's no fuss. It's no demand on doing it if you don't want to. But that's how I get a chance to interact with you all. I try to see you all's point of view and y'all's stance on stuff, or what y'all feel about a particular a subject matter, whatever we're discussing that night or that day. And that's how we, like I said, we stay informed and in tune with one another's train of thoughts, okay? Because sometimes I be having my only way of thinking. I can't see no other way. Then somebody will write me a long letter, or they'll summarize it for me. And it make me think like, okay, yeah, I didn't really think about it that way. They are right. You know what I'm saying? Not saying I was wrong, but I'd be like, yeah, I could see their viewpoint on that issue. Okay, and that's how we learn. We grow together, okay? We understand a little bit better by and by. But okay, that was it for this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Okay, stop coming over to the house eating free. Come bring some food sometime and hit that subscribe button and that like button. Alrighty then. And don't forget to share my videos, guys. Good night.